Instead of the music we normally have this week. Instead of the music we normally have this week, you're gonna have me singing because for a reason I'll tell you in just a moment. Hey everyone, let's see if I'm broadcasting. Oh, that wasn't what I meant to do at all. I hope that didn't screw things up. That would be bad. Hey, so guess what? Now, why am I getting the red signal again? All right, I have to know, are we broadcasting? Because it looks like I'm broadcasting. Dawn says, hey, I see me there, but I keep getting this red signal on my screen here that says, oh no, you're not broadcasting. You think you're broadcasting. You want people to think you're broadcasting, but oh no, this red line says you're not, and I don't know why. And as long as we're looking into technical errors, let me just click over here real quick. And it is saying that something's not working because I'm trying to also stream to YouTube and that's not working. And so maybe that's what it thinks. Maybe that's what it's telling me. Hey, dude, one of your sources isn't working. You don't need to know any of this, do you? So first of all, welcome to the broadcast. My name is Bob Doyle. I'm one of the featured teachers of The Secret, and I am sitting here scrambling to get this screen up here so I can say hello to Sasha and Brian and Jory and Dawn officially. Welcome. Every Wednesday at noon Pacific, well, we gather here, right here on this Facebook page. Pretty nice in here, isn't it? We had such a great response to the background last week, I just had to bring it back. Plus, didn't have time to look for anything else. Okay, so look, you know what happened? So I decided that I was gonna, because Lynn asked me the other day, wasn't the other day, it was 2 weeks ago. She said, hey, are you putting all of your Law of Attraction Q&As on a YouTube channel somewhere, or YouTube playlist somewhere? No. So I did that. So I went and got all this stuff, and I've got a playlist of all of the past Law of Attraction Q&As. It's pretty exciting, isn't it? Would you like to know how to find it? I'll tell you, if you'd like to know. Only if you want to know. If you don't want to know, I'm not going to, look. Did you see that? These jumped out of my ear. So these great headphones I got that stay in my ear because they clamp on, ironically, now that I've got glasses to help me see better, the glasses themselves are causing problems with the whatever. This is so disconcerting seeing this thing flashing like this, like that I'm not broadcasting. But I see me, so it's lying. All right, so anywho, what was I saying? Oh yeah, headphones falling out. That's not it. Oh, tell us. All right, I will. I'm going to write it down right here. It's basically you just go to my YouTube channel. Not the Bob Doyle Show YouTube channel, which is, I know, where everyone wants to go and should be going when they're not going here. Beyond reason. This isn't the link to the actual playlist itself. It's just the regular YouTube channel. And then, yeah. And then you'll find my playlists there, and you'll find the Law of Attraction Q&A one. But see, it's not broadcasting like it should, so I'm going to have to manually upload this. I think I had to do that last time, too, at least for the Bob Doyle Show. What am I on about? Well, first of all, if you're here for the first time, welcome, and get used to a little bit of scattered thinking and talking at the beginning of each of these broadcasts, because that is how Bob Doyle, let's not bring politics into this. That's how Bob Doyle rolls, and I think that most of you who are here know that. Hello, Michelle. Nice to have you back again. And, Bob Doyle, LOA, all in one place. Well, I wouldn't go that far. All in one place, although there is a lot of stuff there on that YouTube channel. A lot of people don't know about it. So if you're here for the first time and you're learning about that channel for the first time, well, congratulations. You just found a treasure trove of free Law of Attraction-related information, just like here. A treasure trove. You get the treasure trove part, right? I hope you're feeling either treasured or troved, one or the other. Otherwise, one of us is wasting our time. Okay, so look, this is a question-driven program. And when I say program, it doesn't mean that I've programmed anything. Well, I guess I did bring us to this lovely spot. But that's not what we mean by program, is it? It's just a scheduled gathering that we do every week. And I remind you every 30 seconds of who I am, just in case you have a short-term memory issue, which who of us don't these days? Am I right in today's scattered world? I need to be reminded of who I am every 30 seconds. By the way, you're free to share this broadcast with anyone and everyone you have ever known. I'll wait while you do that. You back already? Awesome. Well, then this it should get pretty crowded in here. By the way, it's not flashing red anymore. All's good. All right. So see what we did there? We manifested a green light. But I don't think I'm broadcasting. Let me just see if I am. I'm not. I mean, not over to YouTube. So I'll have to upload. These are not your concerns. So how this works is you ask me questions here in the comments area. If you're here and not saying hello, well, what? That's not. Now, come on. This is a social thing. The whole purpose of doing this is so that I'm not just hiding behind email or a web page, but I'm right here. This is live, you know. Live. Anything could happen. Anything could happen. But it probably won't, so we'll just answer your questions. But sometimes I come to this program with an idea of something, a little topic, a thread. I have a few of those in my back pocket, just in case no one has any questions. Of course, if no one has any Law of Attraction questions, why am I doing this broadcast? Maybe I should just stop. Maybe I should just say, you know what? Everyone knows everything, so my work here is done. On to the next thing. This is the On to the Next Thing dance. How many of you are doing that right now in your lives? Well, look, I entertain me, so isn't that what's important? All right, I'm seeing absolutely no conversation going on in here. What? I'm not going to look up there and see. Oh, wait a minute. I'm in the right place. I'm not going to go see how many numbers are here. Ruche! Oh, wait. Oh, I was looking in the wrong place, wasn't I? Holy moly. Was I really? Let me just check. I don't know where I was looking, but here's all your comments, so forgive me. 1,000 pardons. Okay, Ruche, I will see my inbox, but let me address that, actually. Difficult colleagues, what do you do when you're following the law time and time again, but seeing very little positive results? And hello from Steve. Okay, wow, that's a lot of questions. If I forget your question, just remind me. Boy, this is weird with my glasses, though, see? But the good news is, I do have glasses now, so I can read your comments. I expected a little more enthusiasm than that, so thank you. Thank you, glasses. Thank you very much. So, Ruche, I want to address this, and please don't take this the wrong way. This is a general for everybody, and I haven't even read your message yet, so I don't know what I'm talking about in terms of you, so just don't take this personally. You just triggered something that I needed to say. I addressed last week that I get a lot of messages in my inbox here on Facebook, and I try to address the general, you know, if there's a theme of questions there, like relationships and whatnot, I try to address them here on the program. Sometimes that's way more efficient than me answering every single one of those personally. So I do ask that you come and watch this free broadcast or the replay on a regular basis. Why not? Why not? It's good to get a little LOA injection every week. It's good for me. All right. But anyway, my point being, I sometimes get questions, and I got one of these a couple of days ago, and somebody will say, I just need to talk to you, you know, or I have something to discuss with you, but they don't tell me what it is or anything like that, that I'm not going to respond. You know why? Not because I'm mean, not because I don't care, because I simply do not have time to go, well, what is it that you are telling me to talk about? And then go back and forth all day to see if it's even something that is appropriate for us to talk about. So anytime anybody addresses me with a inbox thing or see your inbox or whatever, I just want you to know that, you know, you need to give me as much information as possible in all of those messages so that I can either point you to a resource that already exists that will answer it, which I often do, or so that I can address it completely without a lot of, well, what is it that the thing, you know, a bunch of questions, because that's just, you just have to understand how much I get, and I can't possibly function in that way. All right. Difficult colleagues. All right. Well, see, so all of these things, and we've talked about this, a colleague is like any other relationship, okay? They're people that you have attracted into your lives because there is some sort of vibrational alignment. In this case, you all share a workspace. Okay, you are all working for the same company. There's a lot of energy that's common between all of you, but then you also all bring in your own individual stuff, right? You know, your own things. Now, there's so many levels to this. It seems like an easy question. Here's the quickest, and then I'll work backwards or forwards or sideways or whichever direction it is. You know, number one, it's your interpretation. Difficult is something that you are interpreting, not that they're being. Ooh. They're being how they do it. They're being them. To you, it occurs as difficult because it's not how you operate. To them, it's how they do it. So you have to understand that in most, I mean, and look, everyone in your company may agree that those people are difficult, but what's really happening is everyone in your company has the same interpretation of that behavior. So, first of all, you have to understand that it's all about interpretation, and a lot of it's agreed interpretation. Everything that annoys us, everything that makes us mad, and all of that kind of stuff, so much of it, I should say, is learned responses. So it's a very tricky thing, the things that trigger us and cause us to think this person's difficult or I don't like this person or whatever. There's so much going on that has nothing to do with the person. So that's the first deep thing you have to know. So given that, how then can you change the lens through which you look at these people? So there's other things. You know, why do you suppose that you're working with people that make you uncomfortable or that are difficult? Or do you like your job overall? See, for each of these types of questions, there's so many follow-up questions I would need to ask to get to, here's probably why it's happening to you specifically. Because we all attract difficult people into our lives based on our vibration, what's going on with us personally. There's no one blanket answer for everybody. So the reason you attract people who are difficult is going to be different than the reason that somebody else attracts a person that is difficult in some cases. So hold on. So you look at difficult people like an opportunity for a lesson. They trigger you. They trigger you into going, ugh. These people are so difficult. Why are they so difficult? Why can't they just be easy like me? But it's an opportunity for you to look at what got triggered. Thank you. I was trying to find words and I couldn't. What got triggered in me? It's an opportunity for you to look at yourself and go, wow, okay. This is a thing for me. This is an energetic thing in me. I get triggered by this. What I'm suggesting is that if you work on your own internal triggers, it's not to change them, right? But with the intention that you're going to, for your own good, to take care of yourself, you're going to adjust how you respond. And some of that means going back and looking at, why do I respond like that in the first place? Like, who am I really responding to? Because chances are, by the time it's a colleague, it's not them. It's probably a parent or a sibling or a something from way back. You see where I'm going with this? Okay. Oh, I got quiet again. No one has said a word. But I guess you didn't want to interrupt me because that would be rude, right? Just talking and talking and talking while I'm sitting here trying to say something. Okay, so that's just food for thought for you, Salcedo. In the meantime, when you're triggered and feeling unhappy and difficult, you can do something like EFT or some other release technique, which is what you're going to need to be doing to kind of get to the root of your own resistance, which attracts these people, because it is this persistent energy in you. You are aligned with those people with all of their difficulties for some reason. And that's why I say that the triggers are an opportunity for you to learn a lesson, to grow. And then when you do that, when you resolve that, there's all sorts of things that could happen. These people could stop being difficult or stop occurring to you as difficult. They might move on. You might move on. So David says, what do you do when you're following the law time and again? But see, so here's another, we have a whole litany of questions I could ask you, because following the law can mean 8,000,016 things. I think that's the updated number as of this morning. Because we all have different ideas about what following the law means, don't we? Well, there's a lot of different overall schools of thought, and I know that mine is very different than a lot of people out there in the industry. So it depends on who you learn from, what the law is to you, your understanding of the law. Because this whole idea, this conversation that you're having with yourself right now about how you're following the law and it's not working is affirming a pattern in you which is going to cause that to continue. Trust me, the law of attraction is working flawlessly in every moment. It can't break. So the question really is, you know, you are seeing, why am I not seeing very, very little positive results? Again, I would have to ask you, well, what are the results that you're trying to see? Why do you want to see those? What resistance areas might you have around those specific areas that you're trying to attract, right? I mean, all of those things, like if you're not seeing results with money, well, let's find out what your issues around money are, or relationships, or whatever. So there's not, again, it's not about that it's broken, and even that you're doing it wrong. It's just that there's still some energy running within you that you just need to resolve around these particular areas. Again, if you're finding yourself stuck in a particular area, this is an opportunity for you to go, okay, this is the area for me to work on. What am I blocking here? Am I blocking happiness? Am I blocking money? Am I blocking success? Am I blocking, you know, love? What am I blocking? And then kind of, you know, work on those issues. Because the law of attraction will continue to work completely appropriately and flawlessly, you know, in relation to what you're vibrating, what your energy is. So if you've got that stuff going on in there, it's going to keep occurring for you that way. No one has said anything. I've got no further questions right now. And you know what's going to happen if I don't get my next question? I'll tell you. I'm going to start talking about virtual reality again. No, Bob, don't do it. It's unavoidable, guys. I actually have unbelievably huge and important announcements to make around boundless living, virtual reality, our future as a company, and let me just cut to it. We'll just take a little break here while the next questions come rolling in, and then I do have another little law of attraction related thing I can throw into the mix. But let me just talk about this just for a second, because this is this could be an opportunity for some of you. I have no idea. And I'm going to do a much more formal announcement and a more structured thing about this. But you guys are my peeps. You guys are my, you know, if you show up to these things, you're like the inner circle. So you're going to know things most people don't know. That's just the way it is. So Boundless Living, the company that has been serving your law of attraction needs for the past 12 years or so, is going in a completely new direction. The law of attraction stuff will continue to be out there, continue to serve you. I will continue to do these things for as long as I can breathe, or that it's fun. But I love doing it. But Boundless Living, the company, is adding a whole new thing, which is virtual reality. And this will be very different than Boundless Living of the past, in that Boundless Living in the past has been a Bob Doyle presentation, and I've had help from various people along the way, customer service people this time. This is going to be a whole new, like a real company, like with a place, with the studios and developers and staff and the whole thing, because my vision for it is not huge. I don't need it to be huge. Here's what I want. I want Boundless Living to make a mark in the virtual reality space and produce some titles that benefit people, that allow people to experience the positive benefits that virtual reality and augmented reality are going to provide. And I want Boundless Living to be among the first, and certainly in the personal development space, to be doing that. And I want to do it right. So my very first number one person I need, if any of you know this person, and I'm talking about, I'm looking for the best that I can find who are willing to play along. So that's the other part. But the first person I need is basically a business partner, someone who understands traditional business very, very well, understands all the moving pieces, knows what kind of staff we need, what departments we need, what legal stuff we need. I mean, I'm entering a whole new domain, and there's tons of stuff I don't know. And one of the things that I'm going to be doing is sharing the building of this company on on our company, on the new company website, which will be starting as a blog, where I'm basically saying, hey, I'm starting a company. I don't know what I'm doing. Come along and watch. So there's two reasons. Well, there's probably several reasons that I'm doing that. One is it'll help keep me organized and accountable to post this, and it'll just be interesting historically to be able to look back and go, hey, look how it started. Look at where I got stuck. Look at how I thought I was going to give up, and look how I moved through it, and look what we did. That's the journey that I'm anticipating. You know, I don't have to get stuck, by the way. That's, you know. But I also am doing that to show any of you that if you have a vision, whatever it is, in my case, it's to create a virtual reality company, right? You don't have to know how to do it. The most important thing is that you have the vision and are not afraid to go out there and say, hey, everybody, this is my vision. Who's on board? I went through years thinking that if I don't know how to do it, I can't do it. You know, I would love to have a virtual reality company, but I don't know how to do any of that. I don't know how to program virtual reality. I don't know any of that. So I guess I can't. Some of us are visionaries. Some of us are programmers. Some of us are, you know what I'm saying? So what are you? You know, if you are a person with a grand vision, but you don't know how to make it happen, stop trying to figure out how you yourself are going to make it happen. Go find help. And this is a huge experiment for me. It's a lot of letting go of control, and it's got a lot of trust, you know. And I keep throwing my age out there, but at 50 years old, I'm like, let's try life this way. Yeah, I'm totally creating a whole new thing. Instead of looking at like 15 years down the road and going, maybe I'll retire or whatever, I want to start a whole new thing. You know, because I'm so excited about virtual reality and augmented reality and where it's going to go. Absolutely is going to go, with or without me or you. So, you know, my passion is to share with people the positive aspects that this technology is already and will bring into our lives. Of course, just like every other technology, some people are going to abuse it. There's going to be the dark side. No question. Probably already is. But there is amazing opportunity for good as well. Is that about your VR literature when you think it's going to roll out such a perfect value they love to visualize? Oh, were you saying that as I started to talk about it? That's funny. Well, yes, Terry, that's right. Ask and you will receive. And ask and you will receive. And you, and you, and you. I'm pointing to each of you individually. I don't know how long this is going to take, but, you know, each of you. Just go out and ask. And again, I'm going to have to go from feeling like really confident, like, oh, I've been running a company for 12 years. I know what I'm doing. I know how this works, too. I have no clue what's going on. You got to help me. Right? I probably won't use that tone of voice. But, you know, this means creating strategic partnerships with all sorts of hardware companies and different things. I have so many ideas, it's crazy. And because part of the mission of Boundless Living VR is not just to create these programs, but to also be sort of an evangelist, if you will, for the technology. So I'd be sharing hardware and innovations and things. Basically, I'd be even sharing my competitors, because I can't enter into this space with a competition mindset. I mean, there's just no way. Where it's too creative, there's too many opportunities, there's too many cool ideas, you know, I think, and it seems to be kind of how even the industry is working. There's two major players, Oculus Rift and HTC Vive, and there's others, PlayStation, there's others. But like these guys, everybody's playing nice. So that's cool, because we are on such a frontier. And it's just, and I can just tell you from just doing what I've done around here with the apps that I have and the titles that I've bought and downloaded to evaluate, the visceral impact that good VR has on your body and your emotional state is profound. I've gotten so many, now that I'm looking into it all the time, I mean, you know, medical implications. I think I posted something last week on my timeline about it helping paraplegics to walk again, right? Because of the visualization and the way that it moves through your body and has your body talk to itself because it really believes something is happening. And when we get into augmented reality, which is where you basically see your reality, but then there's other computer-generated stuff superimposed on it. So it's mixed. You're walking around your room as if you're walking around your room, seeing everything that's in there, but you're also seeing other things. I posted something about a company called The Void. I think it's called The Void, and they've created this whole amusement attraction in virtual reality where the software, whatever, generating the experience is mapped to actual walls and things, actual building, so that in the reality, in while you're in virtual reality, if you touch a wall, there's really going to be a wall there. And like where there's spider webs in the virtual reality experience, they have string hanging down, so when you move through, you actually feel it. That is the beginnings of huge potential. It could change the way we buy our living spaces. The day will come, trust me. Everything that I'm thinking, I'm not alone in thinking it. There's other people who are far more visionary than me, who are way ahead of me. It's going to happen. If you can imagine it in this space, in the VR space, in the augmented reality, if you can imagine it, it's absolutely going to happen. And that's why I keep going down the road about, are we a simulation or any of that stuff? It's going to happen because that's where we are right now with technology. If we can imagine it, we can freaking create it. And if we can't physically create it, we can certainly create a computer-generated experience of it so that our brain has the same experience or a very similar. It's going to change everything. Not just for games and movies and things like that. All right. No law of attraction questions? Really? All right. Well, I'm gonna just throw this out here too. This is one of, it's only 12:26. Guys, we have 35 minutes left. But if there's no questions, I will turn this broadcast around. Or maybe you're just enthralled. I don't know. It's hard to say. Or maybe I'm not broadcasting. I know I'm broadcasting. I see the bottom of me updating over here. Brought to you by The Bob Doyle Show, bobdoyleshow.com, Fridays at noon on Facebook. That was our little commercial announcement. So here's a ponder for you. How many things in your life do you say you can't, like, oh, I can't do that? When what you really mean, if you think about it, is I won't. And what's the energy between the energetic difference between the two? Let me give you an example. It's really about knowing, and this is just the first example that comes to my mind. But, you know, I have a whole thing about bookkeeping, accounting, anything, because, you know, I'm a creative, and that's just how it is. And I'm the type of creative that does not like to deal with any of that stuff. And so, you know, I went through years going, oh, I can't figure that out. I can't balance this. I can't do that or whatever. Now, there's two different ways you could look at that. Well, you could if you wanted to, you know, you could. Anything's possible, which is true. I could learn anything. You can learn anything. So when we say we can't do something, unless there's something completely like physically impossible about it, we can learn to do just about anything if we really want to, if we're willing to spend the money, spend the time, have the commitment, all of that stuff. We can do just about anything. This is what I've taken on with the Boundless Living VR. It would be very easy for me to say, I can't build a real company because I have no experience. I did not take any classes on that. I don't even know what I don't know. I can't do that. Well, and that has ruled my decision making for a really long time. I've always said, well, I can run a website. I can do simple e-commerce. I can do that. But that was what I was willing to learn. Well, now I've got a bigger vision, so, you know, for me to say, well, I can't do that, is to ignore my vision, which at this stage in my life, as we all know, is unacceptable. So it's really about saying, well, I can't learn, but let's move that aside. Let's go back to the bookkeeping accounting type of stuff. I can't do that. No, what's true is I won't. And when you cross the energetic chasm between can't and won't, there's something very empowering about a won't, something completely disempowering about a can't. I can't. What does that do to you? It just sucks something from you in the minute you say it. I can't do that. As opposed to, I won't do that. I'll get somebody else to do it. You know, I'll find the person to do that. Now look, there's some things in your... No, I'm going to stick to it. Can't and won't. I can't do that. How about even when this is something to think about, I guess, to yourself. Don't try this out in social. Don't try this in real life. But you know, when people ask you, hey, you want to come over this Saturday? We're having some people over. And you say, oh, I can't. When really what you're saying is, I'm not doing that. I don't like those people. But whenever you say I can't, you know you're kind of lying. But at the same time, you don't want to say, I won't be doing that. But oh, isn't it freeing when you can, when you know someone well enough and they invite you into a situation where they pretty much know you probably don't want to do that. And you say, I won't do that. I've got that in a few places in my life. I'm sorry. I don't know why I went down that road. Where are you? Did my internet freeze? Oh, wait a minute. What happened here? I just touched my screen. And suddenly there was all these questions, which seems to indicate that you've been typing questions and they haven't been updating on my screen. But I just touch my mouse and all of a sudden, ta-da, here's all your questions. And now I feel like I'm behind. All right. So Dawn also just started a whole new thing at 50. Awesome. Because that's when we really get mature. Well, you don't know what we're doing until 50 comes. And then it's like, oh, that's how life works. Okay. Now, Salcedo, I just posted this week on my personal timeline. I'm going to type this right now so you can just see it. And it's just down there a little bit. Facebook.com/boundlessliving. I know that should be my company. But I didn't know what I was doing when I joined Facebook. Go there. Scroll down just a little. And I just posted something about relationships from another one of these shows, talking about attracting your ideal partner. Okay. So Patricia, how can I stop negative thoughts? You cannot. Just ended a 40-year marriage and having financial difficulties, having trouble focusing on positive thoughts. Any tips? Well, first of all, having gone through a divorce and faced financial difficulties as a result, I know how unbelievably assaulting those thoughts are. They just don't stop. Wake up at 3:30 in the morning, scared out of your mind. But here's the thing, trying to fight those thoughts it makes it worse. Take it from me. You kind of got to allow yourself to feel the fear. Here's one of the things, let me just speak from my personal experience on this, okay? A lot of us have fatalistic fantasies, if you will, that we don't really see through. For example, This exact situation. You wake up and you're fearing financial difficulties, right? This may not be true for you, but it was true for me. Maybe there's some version of this that's true for you. You wake up and you're panicked. What am I going to do about finances? Because if I don't, something terrible is going to happen. Like there's this vague sort of horribleness. I don't know if you're going to die, you're going to go to jail, I'm going to get sick, whatever. There's just some vague, horrible thing that's going to happen if this situation doesn't solve itself, right? And so what I have found to be helpful is to get as many garbage trucks to run through my apartment while I'm doing a broadcast as possible. And then is to kind of say, instead of fighting that fear of this unknown thing, play it through. Like, okay, what is the worst thing that could happen? Truly, let's play it out. All right, the next thing happens and it's terrible. Let's run that through and run that through and see what really is likely to happen. You're going to go through a roller coaster when you do that. But I'm telling you that processing the fear, processing those things, allowing the negative thoughts to be there without fighting them will allow you to let them move through faster. Because when you fight them, because, oh no, I shouldn't have a negative thought, it's you are fighting a losing battle, as you are experiencing. Oh no, I have these negative thoughts. That whole thing perpetuates negative thinking. And if you have a cursory knowledge of the law of attraction, it shouldn't be difficult to know why that is. You're sitting there focusing on the fact that you've got these negative thoughts. And maybe beating yourself up for the fact that you can't think more positively. Well, look, you're going through a situation. It's, you know, it out here in the real world, you know, it creates a whole chain of events that some of them aren't really fun, and there's emotion involved, and it's just a divorce and that kind of stuff is such a major, it just wreaks havoc on you energetically. So taking care of yourself, getting enough sleep if you can, meditating, keeping your eye on what you want to be the outcome of all this, as opposed to what, you know, what you fear might happen. You know, your job at this point is to take it a day at a time, you know, deal with what really comes up, stay present, try hard not to project what terrible thing is going to happen or might happen. It's really weird because you feel like, well, I need to think this through because something could happen. I'm being irresponsible if I don't think about how I'm going to handle this when or if this terrible thing happens. Right? Does this sound familiar? Hi, Marion. But there's got to be a balance. You got to balance that thinking and that energy and that emotion with, because on the other side, when my life looks like this, whatever that is, your body is also probably stressed. And your brain doesn't function properly. Nothing functions properly. You know, when you're in such a high fight or flight state that you can get in a situation like this. So be gentle on yourself. And also know that lots of other people have gone through what you're going through and come out on the other side. But what's really going to be important for you is to have that vision so that you're not just mired in fixing the problems that you're having, but that you know you're going somewhere. You know, like this is why I must get through this with a smile on my face and a positive outlook as much as humanly possible. You know, you generate positivity through this vision that you have and what it's going to feel like when you have it. Not trying to force positive thoughts when you're in the midst of a negative thing. So, yeah, those are my tips. I mean, and on top of that, all the releasing stuff that come, you know, the EFT or whatever you want to use to deal with the intensity of the emotion when it comes up, the fear. Breathing helps a lot. I got a great piece of advice from somebody that anxiety and that stress that comes up and releases all the, you know, the stress hormones and stuff, that actually by just deep breathing, you actually dissipate some of the adrenaline. You get the adrenaline going. That's what I was looking for. Your adrenaline starts kicking into overdrive because you're in this fight or flight, and that breathing, deep, heavy breathe, not heavy, like, you know what I'm talking about. Nice, deep, relaxing breaths can sort of dissipate that and calm you down. Because your body, I am really giving you a long answer. But maybe it's helping other people. I don't know. Or they've all left and said, wow, that never happens to me. I'm not stressed about anything. I've got nothing to learn here. Anyway, those are a few things. All right, now what's happening? I'm going to touch my screen again and see if comments magically appear. They did not this time. I don't know why that worked before. Oh, I'm on the wrong page. Am I? Oh, no, I'm not on the wrong page. There we go. Weird. Recognize that thoughts are not truth. They're just thought. Eckhart Tolle talks about this in The Power of Now. Yeah, yes, if you can get through Eckhart Tolle's stuff and stay with it, I love it. Hold on. Man, is it helpful. Ego, thoughts, being present. It's a great learning resource for helping you to attain peace in the moment. Every time, Marion says, every time I get ahead money-wise, something comes up and I have to dip into savings to pay for whatever. With a show of hands, ladies and gentlemen, how many people has that happened to? Man, I wish I had a graphic of like 3 or 4 more hands coming up here. That would just be cool. Yeah, that's a common thing, and there's again, there could be so many different energetic things behind that. There could be deserving issues. You could have experienced, like I did, the trauma of being at the top of your game and then everything being pulled out from under you. Like the it's going to be taken away from me belief. Whatever good happens to me, it's going to be taken away. That is one that I've had to work on for years. If it's good, it won't last. Right? And that kind of belief system or pattern that's running, wherever that came from, will dictate an experience of reality exactly like what you're talking about. So Patricia, should you focus on your future goals? Well, yeah, I think I said this delay, but yeah, the whole vision, focusing on your vision. What do you, yes, your vision for your happiness. Thank you, June. That's very nice of you to say. I'm sorry I didn't see you say that earlier. I just don't understand what the deal is. See, it did it again. I just shook the screen a little bit and knew something's weird. All right, so let's see. I can't scroll down, Camonila. I can't go down any further than this for some reason. I don't know why. I can see them after the fact, but while I'm broadcasting, I can't. How do you know when to wait versus when to act? Wait a minute. How do you know when to wait versus when to act to get what you want? Well, look, your intuition is giving you information at all times. You know, and it generally comes up at the time to take action on it. So if you're getting the nudge to do something, that's probably the time to do it. Again, this is one of those things where there's no set answer for you because I don't know what you're talking about. Like, wait for, like, what's the situation? Every single situation could be different. Your, what determines when you should wait could be completely different than somebody else based on what's normally stopped them or causing them to wait or caused them hesitancy in the past. You see, folks, that's why I have such an issue with the industry itself saying, here's your one-size-fits-all law of attraction solution. Here's what you do when this happens. Well, only if all of these things are true. I think what it is it's just too complicated for a lot of teachers who want to just sell a quick package and say, here's the law of attraction, three easy steps. It's far too complicated because we're getting into quantum physics and belief systems and things that are just so at a quantum level. To actually be able to help everybody individually, you would have to talk to help every, you know, that everybody has a completely unique energetic fingerprint. And your limiting belief about something could be caused by something totally different than another person. So the same approach for the same two people isn't necessarily going to work. And that is unfortunately how the industry works. They try and hit as many people with a solution as possible, right? But it leaves those who it doesn't apply to feeling like, well, then this is all a bunch of BS because it didn't work for me. It's just a flaw with the system. How do you know when... Oh, no, you asked that already. Recognize thoughts for truth. I'm just seeing if I can shake myself some new comments again. Do I have an email ad? Email ad so I can be coached. Okay, so I have... There's a coaching. I have a whole Facebook group of coaches who have been certified by me. You can just do a Facebook search here on Boundless... Hold on a second. I think it's just... Facebook.com. I think it's just Boundless Living Coaching. I hope. Just go there. You can ask questions there. I don't do one-on-one coaching anymore, personally, but my coaches do. And there's also BoundlessLivingCoaching.com. You can go and check that stuff out. Okay. And you can, you know, you can send me a personal message here on Facebook too. But the one-on-one coaching, I don't do it anymore. Alrighty. That's why, but I do it this way. I like doing it this way. Because I get to do it with a waterfall in the background. And that's just the best way to do anything. Oh, I forgot to tell you why the show didn't start with music today. Because once I posted these things on Facebook, I mean on YouTube, to create the Q&A playlist, what happens? I get a freaking copyright violation for the music that I use. Now, I get all my music from a source that I have license to use. So I know I have permission to use it, but I cannot for the life of me find that piece of music in that library again to go, look, here it is. But I don't get my music from anywhere else, so except unless I write it. and I did not file a claim against myself. So I have to come up with another theme, and I probably will use something I write myself, because why wouldn't I? It's just I haven't done it yet. So that's the way that works. Okay, what is going on now? I don't know. Serious lag. No, I think there is a serious lag. Don't worry, Donna. It is not just you. Here's Mike, ladies and gentlemen, with a question. Can you give me some tips or advice on a new business I'm starting in home services? I want to think big, but not too big. I don't feel that it's possible or have limiting beliefs. Is there a happy medium? Well, you want to get out of your comfort zone, Mike. You don't want to just go to right where you're comfortable and don't think that you might have to grow a little or go through some discomfort, because that's not going to give you the juice. You know, so home services, don't know what that, I mean, that could mean a lot of different things, but I would certainly want to know about your passion for it. What drives that passion? Why home services? And then why not too big? Why not? What is too big, and what qualifies the word TOO to be in there? At what point does success or does the company get too big? Because that's going to be a different idea for any one particular entrepreneur. And you are going to determine that something is big because of some sort of belief about where does easy meet hard, small meet large, right? Which isn't a universal truth by any stretch of the imagination. It's your opinion about it. So we'd want to do a little digging on that. But the happy medium is to find the happy medium. Like, what feels really, really good? And then maybe push that vision a little bit further. Like, what would make that feel even better? You know? And then what would I need to make that happen? Not necessarily that you have to figure out all the details, but like, well, I'd need somebody who knows how to do that, or I would need that knowledge, or I would need that kind of a resource, or something like, you know, whatever. It is a serious lag. What if the lag was like 2 hours? Oh, I just realized that. Hold on a second, if I can fix this real quick. Nope. You can kind of see through me. You can see right through me. I admit it, today's broadcast was, again, last minute, because up until 15 minutes before I came on live here, I was working on a 30-second promo for the Bob Doyle Show, because somebody wants that and has been asking for it for 2 weeks. That's a difficult thing for me to go, I just got 34 shows. I got to come up with a 30-second promo of this show that I already can't describe. Weird. All right, I'm going to try again. Let's see if this just makes comments appear. Yes, it did. What is going on, Facebook? All right. It's not just you, Donna. No, Michelle and Camila. A-O in Swedish. A-O in Swedish. See, the lag is so bad, we have no idea what that could possibly mean or what she's referring to. I'm just glad you're participating. Camomila. Is that, am I saying that right? Is this your first time here on a Wednesday? Well, I'd love it. Who else is here for the first time? If you're here for the first time and you're still here, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. I'm not going to just sit around and wait for this, because, I mean, you know, for you to answer, because we've already established that it takes forever. But there's no questions there. I've talked about can't and won't. I could go on and on about virtual reality, but I will not. So maybe I'll just wrap it up here, ladies and gentlemen. But look, every Wednesday we do this. Right? Some of us are here all the time. I know I am. One day I had to put it off by a day. And that may happen again. After all, it is a free show. Nobody's subscribing to this and paying hard-earned dollars so that if I'm not here on a... What am I talking about? Doesn't matter. They're all archived here on this page, the Bob Doyle Law of Attraction Resources page, and at the YouTube playlist that I shared with you earlier in these in the comments at youtube.com/wealthbeyondreason, where you will find lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and other videos as well. And you'll see me looking young and clean-shaven with hair slicked back all the way to whatever this look is that I'm cultivating. the post 50 bearded hanging on desperately to youth. I don't know. Is that what I'm doing? I don't feel like it. I think my youth is desperately hanging on to me. I think that's actually what's happening. All right. Okay, it's really weird to not have music to go out on because I really like that music so much. It was always just so, you know, what do we got here? I don't think we have anything. There's really just, I'm just trying to see. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching the Law of Attraction Resources Q&A with Bob Doyle from The Secret, the opus, Try It On Everything, Beyond Belief, and perhaps even some other films that he's not aware that he's a part of. Every Wednesday, noon Pacific, right here on Facebook, and don't forget The Bob Doyle Show. Fridays, BobDoyleShow.com. I hope you're all dancing along with me. All right, well, I got to do my whole getting ready to fade to black thing. Are you all ready? You remember when to show up again?